Okay, so I'm here to represent the Bonanza Creek LTER, which you might also know as the Taiga LTER. That's a Russian word for the land of little sticks, which is very evocative of where we work. Okay, so a little bit of news. As of September, I became the new PI, and I have with me a new leadership team. And we've been working together over the last 2 years to assemble a more inclusive structure for our program. We've been working on strategic planning, on reorganization of leadership. We've done climate surveys. We've been really focused on justice, equity, diversity, and inclusion, and we have our eye on that renewal proposal that goes in the spring. We've been active in inReach. So this is a term coined by Terry Chapin to describe communities reaching into the LTER for reciprocal knowledge sharing. And what we've got is this fantastic program led by Mary Beth Lee in a time of change, where artists and humanity scholars are coming into the LTER and working with scientists. And this group has been meeting almost weekly over the last year. We've got Fostering Science, a summer camp that serves youth in foster care and uses ideas of science methods and resilience to provide an experience for a group of kids that usually doesn't have access to these types of opportunities. We've also been working with community colleges in Southern California to provide field research experiences for these students. And we're now working on an Alaska Native Advisory Council, and this will bring in the perspective of rural Alaska Natives to the LTER so that we can better position our research to serve their needs. Okay, so finally today, I want to talk about one new project that really addresses the themes of this Science Council meeting. For the last 20 years, we've been studying the long-term effects of increasing wildfire activity on ecosystem dynamics and the biospheric feedbacks to warming climate. Now, these fires are started by lightning. They burn in the wilderness where, at least according to this construct you see here, the only human hand is this anthropogenic climate warming. So the blue arrows coming down here. Yeah. Okay. And here's a picture showing you the human hand reaching down and unlocking the carbon storage, the legacy of past ecosystems. So burning through thick organic soils and releasing that carbon to the atmosphere. And we've also focused on the consequences of burning and the soil disturbance for population dynamics and the unfolding of successional trajectories, and then how this in turn feeds back to carbon cycling. All right. So if we look closely at these forests, though, we know that there are humans embedded there. You can see the little community that's next to this big wildfire plume. And like many other places in the Western United States, fire suppression activities just immediately around rural communities have led to aging forests that are highly flammable. And so we know that there's both a top-down effect of increasing fire weather and a bottom-up effect of aging fuels that together create a bullseye of risk around rural communities. And this really puts humans into our loop, please. Okay, so this is putting humans and the mitigation of fire impacts on communities into our understanding of biosphere atmosphere feedbacks. Now, we can't suppress these fires, but we can mitigate risks to communities by constructing fuel breaks. So these are treatments of forests that reduce the fuels directly around communities. And of course, it's easiest and cheapest, at least for immediate construction costs, to bulldoze or cut down a forest. It's unlikely, though, that that kind of treatment is going to be sustainable either for the people or for the plants, because successional processes will have their ways over time. So we need low flammability forests that support the needs of communities, traditional subsistence practices, spiritual and aesthetic connections to the land. We also need low flammability forests that are economic to construct and that persist over time with relatively little human maintenance or intervention in natural successional processes. All right. And so this is our new project. We want to use knowledge co-production to design these fuel breaks. And together, ecologists and other types of academic scientists, we're working with Native organizations, with towns in rural Alaska and with various fire scientists at agencies in Alaska to build an integrated framework that we can develop best practices for resilient fuel breaks, sustainable and resilient fuel breaks. And LTER here is engaged in bringing this ecological understanding of disturbance that we've developed over the last two decades to this design process. So designing successional trajectories that nudge forest structure towards long-lived, low flammability forests. And so we're working together with our partners and collaborators to aim for the sweet spot in the center of this Venn diagram to create fuel break best practices that are acceptable to residents, that are economically feasible, and that persist. So we are focused on the ecological design of living fuel breaks that maintain low flammability forests throughout succession. Thank you very much.